Hey everybody, so in this video, we're gonna build a fully functional chat application using React Native in 10 minutes. Links to all the resources are in the description of this video, and if you have any questions, please join the Discord discussion and ask questions. Let's get started and start building this application, which I'm demoing to you here. We need React Native 0.75, Node.js version 18+, JDK 17. Before starting the integration, we need to configure the development environment. If you are developing a React Native project for the first time, please refer to the steps on the React Native official website. Set up your environment to configure your development environment. Step 1. Create a project. This step can be skipped if you already have a project. Now, let's create a new React Native project. Wait for the dependencies to be installed. After the project is created, go to the project directory. Step 2. Integrate ChatWeakit React Native. Download ChatWeakit React Native via npm/yarn and use it in the project. Let's take npm as an example. Next, add device permissions. First, add Android device permissions. We follow the path of Android app src main to find the Android manifest.xml file, and then add the following permissions to this file. Then add iOS device permissions. Add the following permission usage description to the info.plist file. Step 3. Set up navigation. Please install the React navigation dependencies. Here we take npm as an example. Step 4. Import ChatUIKit React Native. Replace the content in app.tsx, or you can create a new component to introduce. Then create a new screens.tsx file in the same directory as the app.tsx file. Next, we need to replace SDK app ID, user ID, and user sig. These parameters are obtained in step 5. Step 5. Obtain the relevant parameters SDK app ID, user ID, and the corresponding user sig from login. First, obtain SDK app ID, click Chat Console, create application, enter a custom application name, select the product type chat, and click Create. This is the created application. Click Application Overview in the upper left corner, copy the SDK app ID, and replace the corresponding content in app.tsx. Then get the user ID, click Application, and select the application just created. You will see the chat product entry in the left sidebar, click to enter. After entering the chat product subpage, click Users to enter the user management page. Click Create Account to pop up the account creation information filling box. For a better to experience with messaging and other features, it is recommended that you create two user IDs. For example, test1, test2. Finally, we need to get the user sig. User sig can be generated in real time using the development tools provided by the console. Click the link. Select the application you just created. Enter the username, which is the user ID. Click Generate. Generate result, which is the user sig corresponding to the user ID. The user ID I filled in is test1, and then replace its corresponding user sig. Step 6. Compile and run the project. To compile and run the project, you need to use a real device or an emulator. It is recommended to use a real device. If you use Android device, enable developer mode on the phone, execute npm run Android to compile and run the project. If you use iOS device, connect the phone with a USB cable and open the project iOS directory with Xcode. Configure the signing information, go to the iOS directory and install dependencies. After the installation is complete, open Xcode, open existing project. Click Signing and Capabilities, and configure the bundle identifier and provisioning profile. Go back to the root directory and execute npm run ios to compile and run the project. After typing cd on, we can also type React Native Run iOS Simulator equals iPhone 16 to specify the simulator version. Successfully launch the app now. Click Login. Let me demonstrate the functions of demo in detail. Click Initiate Session in the top left corner, so we can enter a user's ID, find them, and start a chat. We can send various types of messages like text, emojis, and images. I can quote any message and add my thoughts, and easily jump to that message's location. We can also recall messages, re-edit them, and send them again. Beyond that, we can create a new group by entering the IDs of users we want to add and selecting the group type. For example, let's make this a friends working group. Great, now we've created the group chat, and we can edit the group's name. For both group chats and individual contacts, we have options to pin, mute, or delete the chat.